The soft flurries flutter as summer takes rain. Before the tower, locust leaves form a rounded chain. Good morning, today is Sunday, May 5, 2024. Today in history, on this day, 206 years ago, the German thinker, political scientist, and philosopher Karl Marx was born. Known for his seminal works such as Das Kapital and the Communist Manifesto, Marx pioneered the philosophical concept of historical materialism. He remains an influential figure as the revolutionary mentor of the proletariat and working people worldwide, as well as the spiritual leader of the proletariat and the founder of the international communist movement. Today, according to the Chinese lunar calendar, marks the traditional solar term known as the beginning of summer. With this term, sunshine and thunderstorms increase, heralding the peak growth season for all things. Qingqiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qingqiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. North Korea accuses US of politicizing human rights. According to the Korean Central News Agency, Turner, the Biden administration's special envoy for human rights, recently visited Seoul, South Korea, and Tokyo, Japan, to discuss the North Korean issue. A spokesman for North Korea's foreign ministry quoted Turner as saying Pyongyang would take severe and decisive actions to safeguard its sovereignty and security in response to Washington's use of human rights as a tool for incursions into North Korea and hostilities. North Korea also criticized the United States for urging it to stop launching missiles and other rockets, while Washington said it violated United Nations resolutions and cited South Korea's launch of a satellite in April. Previously, the U.S. State Department released its annual Human Rights Report by Country, which stated that North Korea has serious human rights problems. The report lists credible information on arbitrary or unlawful killings, including extrajudicial killings, enforced disappearances, and torture or cruel, inhuman, or degrading treatment or punishment by government authorities in North Korea. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. Eastern Ukraine conflict intensifies, Ukrainian troops retreat from three front lines. According to Reuters, on April 28, Commander-in-Chief of the Ukrainian Armed Forces Sersky stated that the situation in eastern Ukraine has deteriorated, leading to Ukrainian forces retreating westward to establish new defense lines. The Russian army's advancement in the east has intensified, with the main battleground near the town of Chasiv Yar and the northwest of Avdiivka, which fell under Russian control in February. Sersky, through social media platforms, reported that his troops had fortified new positions west of the villages of Burdik and Semenivka, as well as near the village of Novomikhailivka to the south, close to the town of Marinka. He acknowledged that Russia holds significant advantages in strength and resources, allowing them to potentially make further advances in the ongoing intense combat. Ukrainian officials are now eagerly anticipating the prompt arrival of long-awaited U.S. military assistance, which they deem crucial in halting Russia's invasion. UN, 14 years, needed to clear rubble from Gaza Strip. United Nations News reported that Lod Hammer, a senior official of the United Nations Mine Action Division, revealed at a Geneva press conference that following Israel's cessation of military operations in the Gaza Strip, an estimated 37 million metric tons of rubble will need clearance and disposal, complicated by unexploded ordnance. In the conflict-ridden Gaza Strip, every square meter contains roughly 200 kilograms of debris, with up to 10% of fired ammunition remaining unexploded. Clearing this rubble with 100 trucks would require 14 years and around 750,000 working days, further hindered by the difficulty of identifying unexploded ordnance in densely populated areas. Simultaneously, UN humanitarian workers cautioned of an imminent famine in northern Gaza and appealed to Israel to permit more aid into the region. Scow, Deputy Executive Director of the United Nations World Food Programme, stressed the absence of concrete famine mitigation measures, emphasizing the necessity for increased aid quantities, predictability, and sustained efforts to provide diverse assistance to the northern region. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. Henteng Malaysia denies plans for casino in Forest City. Comprehensive news from Kuala Lumpur. On April 27, Henteng Malaysia Group issued a statement rebutting reports from Bloomberg, The Edge, and The Straits Times, denying any involvement of Henteng Malaysia Vice Chairman and CEO Lim Kok Fei in meetings or discussions regarding the opening of a casino at Forest City. The statement labeled the reports as untrue and demanded the cessation of false information dissemination by the three media outlets. Henteng Malaysia emphasized its readiness to take further actions to safeguard its interests and those of its stakeholders. Earlier, Bloomberg cited anonymous sources claiming that Malaysian Prime Minister Anwar had met with Lim Kok Fei and Berjaya Group founder Tan Chi Yeon in Forest City to discuss a casino opening, with Sultan Ibrahim's representative allegedly in attendance. The Straits Times, citing sources, suggested that the casino proposal was part of the Johor-Singapore Special Economic Zone project. In response, Malaysian Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim clarified that reports suggesting the government's intention to open a casino in Forest City were entirely false. He emphasized that rumors regarding the exploration of Malaysia's second casino license were unfounded. Additionally, Johor Menteri Besaran Hafiz Ghazi reiterated the falsehood of these claims, affirming that Sultan Ibrahim, the current head of state and Sultan of Johor, had explicitly prohibited the opening of casinos in Johor. Now, here is some important safety information. Over 70% of Japanese health food ads are irregular. Recently, a joint team from Asahi Central Hospital and Kyoto University in Asahi City, Chiba Prefecture, Japan, conducted an investigation into clinical trials commissioned by five major pharmaceutical R&D contract outsourcing service organizations in Japan. Among the 726 clinical trials registered in the public database, 100 were randomly selected, with 76 of them being food-related trials. The investigation revealed discrepancies between the abstracts and trial results in 26 trials. Notably, 11 of these trials were utilized in food advertisements and press releases. Furthermore, the interpretation of 8 trial results was deemed irregular and could potentially mislead consumers, resulting in an irregularity rate of approximately 73%. Researchers highlighted instances where supplements claimed to maintain cognitive abilities, despite several experimental projects failing to confirm their effects. Some trial results were selectively presented to suggest improvements in cognitive abilities, which were then advertised as products that could maintain cognitive efficacy. It is worth noting that functionally labeled foods in Japanese health products only need to provide scientific evidence consistent with their claimed functions for filing and do not require approval from government departments. For instance, Kobayashi Pharmaceuticals' Red Koji health products, despite causing health damage to consumers, fall under this category. Researchers found this 70% irregularity rate concerning. Dozens of tornadoes hit central U.S., killing 5. Dozens of tornadoes have ravaged several Midwestern states, including Nebraska, Iowa, Kansas, and Missouri, since April 26, as reported by Agence France-Presse and Xinhua News Agency. The states of Nebraska and Iowa were particularly hard hit, with numerous homes destroyed, several people injured, and 5 fatalities reported. Emergency declarations have been issued for affected areas in both states. Additionally, severe storms struck parts of Arkansas and Texas, leaving nearly 52,000 Texas residents without power. Meteorologists have cautioned that the central United States remains at risk of flash floods, hail, and tornadoes in the coming days. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. New York prosecutors returned 30 stolen cultural relics to Cambodia and Indonesia. According to Agence France-Presse, the U.S. Attorney's Office in New York has recently repatriated 30 stolen cultural artifacts to Cambodia and Indonesia. These relics, valued at $3 million in total, were previously trafficked by American antique dealers and smugglers. Manhattan District Attorney Bragg stated that in 2 recent repatriation efforts, 27 artifacts were returned to Phnom Penh, including a bronze statue of the Hindu deity Shiva stolen from Cambodia, while 3 artifacts were returned to Jakarta, including a stone relief of 2 royal figures from the Majapahit Kingdom on Java Island. It is reported that during Manhattan District Attorney Bragg's tenure, the U.S. authorities seized nearly 1,200 stolen cultural artifacts from at least 25 countries, with a combined value exceeding $250 million. Investigations into trafficking networks targeting cultural artifacts from Southeast Asia are ongoing. New York, being a major hub for antiquities trafficking, has seen the recovery of many lost artifacts from local museums, including the prestigious Metropolitan Museum of Art, as well as from private collectors in recent years. Financial newsletter. According to Chihua Daily, the price of Australian manganese ore imported through Tianjin port has surged from 34 yuan per ton unit to 54 yuan per ton unit, marking an increase of nearly 60%. This significant rise is primarily attributed to the disruption in operations at the main manganese mine of South32, the world's largest manganese ore production company. That's all for today's Qingqiao Morning News. Thank you for listening.